disease pretty much the same as what my mom has. I've been having so much pain for the last year, and I just want some answers.
So, Randall, I know you have a lot of questions. So I'm going to start off by explaining a little bit about what inflammatory bowel disease. And I pardon you for having my back to you, but we're going to do this. So inflammatory bowel disease, what it is, it combines basically the two diseases, Crohn's disease and both also ulcerative colitis. And they're autoimmune diseases in which your body's own immune system attacks. So Crohn's disease is most commonly affects the end of your small intestine where it enters your large intestine, your colon. But it can extend all the way from your mouth to your penis, the whole digestive tract. And it's you can kind of differentiate it because it extends to the whole lining of the intestinal wall. So
I don't understand why my immune system is responsible for the pain I'm in.
Okay, inflammatory bowel disease, what happens is we have normal bacteria that roam throughout our digestive tract, right? So our immune system, for whatever reason, thinks that, hey, this is a foreign antigen instead of a normal bacteria. So it attacks it, basically, and it continues to attack it, thinking it's fighting a battle. And in that fight of the battle, what it ends up ulcerating the whole inside of the digestive tract. So that's what that is. So with that Crohn's disease, like I said, you can have from anywhere on any of the linings. So it comes down to your stomach and down to your small intestines and to your colon, all the way out, right? And so, Randall, your problem is right here. Into your large intestine and colon area. So what we have here is Randall had previously, the prior 2 days, he had a colonoscopy, and these are actual, this is not really actual. So anyway, this is a colonoscopy, and this is Crohn's disease. That's exactly as the ulcer that it forms. Now, up here is an advanced stage. So these things are called skip lesions, and what happens is, thing is that your immune system is attacking different areas. You get these things called skip lesions, and it causes ulceration in different areas. See, like how there's an ulceration here, here, kind of skips around, and after a while, you get these lesions. In your trap, which is it's going to be different than ulcerative colitis, which I'll explain in a second. So Nancy's going to talk about some risk factors.
Okay. So Randall, I'm going to talk about risk factors. You already know some of this because, but anyway, just so you know, you're in the age group that most commonly people are diagnosed with Crohn's between teens and 30s, and family genetics. Obviously, your mother has ulcerative colitis, the same family. So that's a huge one, probably most likely cause of the disease. Race, most people who have ulcerative colitis are either white or Jewish. Are you a smoker?
No.
That's good. And smoking does increase the risk of problems, but not ulcerative colitis. Environment might have a role. People who live in a city or urban areas tend to have higher risk. And even though diet does not increase, different diets will make you get Crohn's, it can exacerbate your problem. So signs and symptoms that you probably are having are diarrhea, cramping, abdominal pain, weight loss, and malnutrition can be a risk for you, low grade fever. And if your Crohn's is quite bad, you could end up with something called a fistula, which is an ulcer that gets so bad that it ends up going into another organ and you have kind of a channel you can do for it. But right now you're in a very early stage of the room, so that's good. Lisa, I'd like to talk some more about
in your intestine, your colon. It's just located in that and down to your rectum. It stays in there, and it only deals with the very surface wall, you know, where the food passes through. That interior surface wall, it only deals with that surface. Now, Crohn's is that whole wall, you know, from the interior to the exterior that it deals with. The other thing with ulcerative colitis, like remember when I was saying about Crohn's disease kind of skips around. You could have an area here, you could have an area in your small intestine, you could have an area in your large intestine, you could have lots of difficult spots. With ulcerative colitis, it kind of tends to be one big patch. It doesn't skip around much. So, we made a little chart here kind of to explain some different differences. And we can kind of just read it. But some of the things that I found that I thought were interesting is that generally, this is good news for you, Randall, the development of cancer is uncommon in Crohn's disease, whereas in ulcerative colitis, it's common. And the other ones are kind of, weight loss is common, not common, you can read we also have a chart to give you before you leave. So, when to call your doctor? So, it's kind of a tricky little thing. I know you're athletic and you like to be active, you're 29 years old. So, part of the good thing about this coming to see us in your colonoscopy is you know now that your symptoms that you're having. So, how to differentiate it is when your symptoms become extreme, like you have extreme bleeding, or you have a great deal of fluid loss, or your nausea and vomiting is extreme, you're going to want to call your doctor. When anything's outside the norm, and you're going to get to know your body, now that you know what's going on, you're going to get to know how to fix it. So, that's that.
who lives in an industrialized area. But I also think that you have a good point in terms of environmental factors. Because it's an autoimmune disease where you're triggering them to attack their own body, and so you're looking at other allergic type reactions aimed toward the body, it can probably be triggered by a lot of environmental causes as well, because we don't respond well to a lot of environmental triggers.
I also recently heard
in
the
PR
study going out that it has the peer review or anything yet, but that maybe the fact that we are more able to get access to antibiotics and things like that may be a factor that we don't have the bacteria, our natural flora is not intact. And that might be why Crohn's is so prevalent.
I'd like to ask a question about the bleeding. You said only to call if there's excessive bleeding. How much is normal?
Well, that depends on sort of his baseline and how he, I mean, people with Crohn's don't tend to have a ton of bleeding. More ulcerative colitis has more bleeding. But there is blood, going to be a little bit of blood with kind of flare-up. So it's sort of hard to, you know, pin down exactly, but it's kind of something he's going to have to feel.
As a general rule, I mean, he probably came in because he had blood and stool to begin with, and that's something that's already part of the baseline. That he's already being treated for, and that he's already being treated for.
I think if it were me with the teaching, I would change the terminology from excessive bleeding to abnormal bleeding. Because excessive would make me think, well, they're going to be like, like hemorrhaging. And I'd be very careful about the way you state that.